Good morning, Prune Hill Penguins. You're watching the KPHE Penguin News Now with your first host, Lisa. Today is Tuesday, December 12, 2023. It is our 65th day of school. There are now 115 days left to go after today. Our number of the day is 65. Can you think of any equations that equal 65? Here's one I thought of. 65 times 1 equals 65. The weather for today looks to be partially cloudy with a high of 45 degrees. Now let's hand things over to Ellie. Bye, Penguins!
Hi, my name is Ellie and I'm your second host for today. It's time to announce our Penguin Pride winners for the week. Whitney in room 2 won Mrs. Swan's chair for the day tomorrow. Adeline in room 11 gets to play Papa Games with Miss Swan. Knox in room 20, Luke in room 19, and Nyla in room 19 get to play Nerf basketball with Mr. Durfee. Roxy in room 11 gets to have the Penguin Trophy. Danny in room 8 will be our recess teacher helper for the week. Emmett in room 22 won the class popcorn party. Finally, Abby in room 17 gets to have extra recess tomorrow. In recent news, representatives of hundreds of nations have been talking at an important climate meeting in Dubai. There has been progress, but there are also challenges. The biggest question is whether to end fossil fuels or just reduce them. Most experts agree that to limit global warming as much as possible, the world needs to end the use of coal and oil. COP28 will be referred in this story, and COP stands for Conference of the Parties, which basically means meeting of the countries that signed the agreement. In this case, the agreement is the 1992 United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. This was the 28th meeting since the agreement was first signed. Over 100 countries say that COP28 should lead to a deal to phase out fossil fuels. The science is clear, said UN leader Antonio Guterres. The 1.5 degree target is only possible if we finally stop burning fossil fuels. Progress on controlling the dangerous greenhouse gas, methane, is probably COP28's biggest success so far. The U.S. has announced a plan to cut methane pollution by 80% over the next 15 years. Many other countries are working on similar programs. Cutting methane pollution will have a rapid and powerful effect on global warming. COP28 is just in its first week, and the meeting will continue until December 12th. Many people are hoping for a lot more progress over the next 7 days. We'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Arlo in room 1, Lily in room 21, and Carson in room 6. Happy birthday! Now, we'll hand it over to Leilani.
Hi, my name is Leilani, and I'm another one of your hosts for today. It's time for announcements about what's happening around the school. The Penguin Sports Clinic for second graders today and Thursday after school. Third graders will continue to have their after-school class in room 6 today and Thursday. Fifth graders will have water quality monitoring tomorrow. There will be a staff meeting in room 20 on Thursday. On Friday, the birthday table will be set up in the cafeteria for all December birthday kids. Now we're turning things over to Olivia to end our broadcast.
Hello, Penguins. I'm Olivia, and I'm your final host for today. Did you know that today is National Gingerbread House Day? Whether you're a cookie building expert or your baked house falls apart as soon as you get the third wall glued on with icing, we can all agree that the best part of building a gingerbread house is eating the sweet treat when we're done. Nothing brings in the holidays like the smell of fresh baked gingerbread. But before the decorative cookie led the popularity contest on the holiday dessert table, baking gingerbread was acknowledged as a specific profession. In the 17th century, only professional gingerbread bakers were allowed to make gingerbread, except at Christmas and Easter, when anyone was allowed to bake it. It's time now for our Penguin Pet of the Week segment. Today, we will get to enjoy seeing pets from Madeline in Room 1, in Boston in Room 1, and Zoe in Room 10. remember to say the Pledge of Allegiance with your class sometime today. Let's all show our penguin pride by being safe, respectful, responsible, and kind. This is Olivia saying goodbye from the Penguin News Studio. Have a terrific Tuesday!